Realizing I'd left my wallet somewhere, I went back to the space station to ask about it, see if anyone had seen it. I mean, they're mainly all a bunch of crooks, so doubt I'll have much luck, but thankfully a friendly Corvax had picked it up near the trade terminal. Relieved that my Gek Hub gold card was safe, I headed over to the tech merchants, to exchange a load of unwanted tech modules I'd acquired from previous milestones. Unknowingly, chatting to the other guys, had not only saved my wallet, and dignity, yes, I'd written my name on the Gek Hub gold card, rookie error, but it had also earned me the milestone, universal language. I then picked up another milestone, Cluster Horde, from handing in the scan fauna discoveries from the previous planet, and the nanites gained from selling the unwanted tech modules. Making a quick exchange at the cartographer for some distress signal maps, I was hopeful that I could find a semi-decent crashed ship to scrap, or a crashed freighter to salvage parts from. I'd been given a tip to head out to a moon called Mapanate in this system. Apparently, there were some valuable crystals that, if I was brave enough, I could collect, but only during a storm. Well, as Brave was my middle name, I couldn't say no to this, so was already on my way, before remembering that in fact, Brave was my brother's middle name. The weather was nasty, but the crystals were easy to spot, so making my way as quick as I could, I collected as many as I could carry, and headed back to the ship to sit out the rest of the storm. My starnav beeped, and I was rewarded with some memory fragments, for completing the milestone, Calcified Echos. Using one of the distress maps I purchased earlier, I headed to the location, keeping my paws crossed for a nice S-class crashed exotic. Arriving at an abandoned building, there didn't seem to be any ship. All I could see was goo, and these purple humming egg things. Shooting one with my mining beam, revealed a glowing egg I couldn't resist taking, but this was quickly followed by an entire swarm, of those nasty green things with big teeth. Jetting over the building, I was able to grab a couple of the mesmerizing eggs, before the swarm spotted me. Heading back to the safety of the roof, I shot as many as I could, until the swarm dispersed. I wanted those eggs. I needed those eggs. In a daze, I went back down, grabbing as many as I could get my dirty little paws on. Moments later, I was once again face to face with the pointiest teeth in existence. In a panic, I hit the jetpack boost, which sent me flying over the building. Landing with a bang, my suit had lost all shields, and the life support was failing, but making it into the building, I managed to get everything back online, before almost certain death. Another beep, some memory fragments, and another milestone, Call of the Void was completed. Let's skedaddle whilst we have the chance. Popping open another map, bingo, a crashed freighter. I set the ship down, and whilst we had a break in the storm, I got straight to work on extracting any valuables from the crates. Thankfully, the locks only required a bit of cobalt to open, so after pillaging all I could carry, I headed back to the ship. This little exercise had completed the milestone, Fallen Giants, and I was rewarded with some more memory fragments. Unexpectedly, another WhatsApp message from Polo, blinked on my screen. He wanted me to head back to the frozen planet and place a small base near a body of water. Apparently, he needed some type of fish, that only spawned on that planet once every 37 years. He didn't explain why, and I didn't ask, but as I wasn't too far away, why not? He's asked me for stranger things in the past. Landing on a small island surrounded by water, I set about making Polo his little shelter. It doesn't take me long, but Polo seems pleased, and I complete another milestone, the anchor. Jumping back in my ship, Polo informs me that the next anchor point is in another galaxy, but he's checked my fuel and I have enough to get there. The cheeky fecker, I wish he'd stop snooping on me like that. I notice from my deep space scans, that there's a black market system on my way, so just to spite Polo, I head toward the system Kievel Izzo. Both Nada and Polo disapprove of pirates, but they need me, so what they gonna do? Heading into the decrepit Eerie space station, and down the long dark passage, I land amongst crates and cables. Stepping out into the dimly lit pirate underworld. How freaking cool is this? Starting to sing, "Bad boys, bad boys, whatcha gonna do?" I realize that I should probably try to blend in. Stumbling across the trader, I purchased all the black market goods he had, and before questions started being asked, returned to my ship and made a quick exit. Punching in the second anchor point's coordinates, I headed toward the system Romestovot. With a ship full of contraband, my first stop was to the station, to offload the illicit cargo for what should be, a stonking profit. Hells yeah baby, look at all those sweet units! Despite making profit from illegal goods, I achieved another milestone, Hot Pursuit. As an odd reward, I received a forged passport. Another one to add to my collection, I guess. Right, let's get to this anchor point, else Pole will just be on my back as per usual. I already have the coordinates set, Alecapae Beta, yet another damn infested planet. Fun times! The sun was setting, so I hope there wasn't too many surprises in store. Setting the ship down, I hopped out and down to the portal. All was quiet, but a ping on my StarNav marked the completion of the milestone, Anchor Point 2. The coordinates for this place are +19.41, +56.60. As it was getting a bit chilly on the nibnibs, I jumped back into my ship, whilst I used the memory resonator to find the coordinates of the next grave marker. It wasn't too far, but no way I was walking in this cold, so a quick pulse and I arrived in a very mountainous region. Damn, Polo doesn't make anything easy, does he? Of course the damn grave was at the top of a nearby hill, so catching my breath, I recovered the memory fragment, achieving the milestone, to Crave the Stars. Expecting the worst, I boosted up the hill, and boy was that a good move. Corrupted sentinels had appeared from nowhere, and were searching for my little geck ass. Finishing them off with my mining beam, I collected the salvaged glass, and headed back to the safety of my ship. I think I'll choose to die another day. With that excitement over, I had completed iteration 2 of the expedition. Sending Polo a WhatsApp to put the kettle on, it's time for a bit of downtime, and a well-earned peanut butter sandwich.